Good morning everybody, welcome everyone. Today's topic is amino acids. So now I am going to discuss about amino acids. We also know that amino acid is the structural unit of protein. Basically, 20 different types of amino acid make diversity of protein. Amino acids are arranged together with the help of peptide bond to make different types of protein. Amino acid is one type of biomolecule that is very much important for especially NEET medical, JAM, HS, class 11, 12, etc. So most of the student get clear concept from this video and from this class. First, I will discuss what is amino acid. Basically, amino acid is one type of biomolecule in where two functional group, alpha C-O-minus and alpha NH3+, these two group must be present. Another one molecule of hydrogen and another X, that is variable. So NH3, hydrogen and C-O-minus, all are common for every amino acid. Why this is alpha? Because from C-O-minus, this carbon is alpha. That's why this group is alpha C-O-minus, this group is alpha NH3+. Anyone say that C-O-minus and NH3+, if present in a molecule, so is it amino acid? But that is not, because NH3+ and C-O-minus, the particular position of NH3+ and C-O-minus at alpha carbon. So this carbon is called asymmetric carbon atom due to four valencies of carbon atom are occupied by four different groups. So terms and condition of amino acid is presence of alpha C-O-minus group, alpha NH3+ group, and only one or maybe two asymmetric carbon atom. Okay, as asymmetric carbon atom is present in a amino acid, that's why amino acids are optically active molecule. That's why it has two isomer, D and L. So if you study the structure of glycine, so there are alpha NH3+ and alpha C-O-minus group, because this is alpha carbon, because from the C-O-minus this carbon is alpha. So alpha NH3+, alpha C-O-minus, both are present, but four valencies are not occupied by four different group due to presence of same group, both are hydrogen. That's why this molecule has no asymmetric carbon atom, though it is amino acid. So glycine is one type of amino acid that has no asymmetric carbon atom. That's why it is optically inactive. So general formula of amino acid is alpha C-O-minus, alpha NH3, H and another branch. So on the basis of this variable group, so there are different types of amino acid. All are common, but that is different. So on the basis of branch chain, there are different types of amino acids. So branch may be charged or uncharged. Charged means there are two types of charged, positive or negative. Uncharged, basically uncharged, that are polar or non-polar. So side chain always possesses positive charge or negative charge. Or uncharged may be divided into polar or non-polar. So on the basis of this four diversity, so there are different types of amino acids. If you follow this structure, so this is alpha NH3, this is alpha C-O-minus, this is alpha H, and this is branch, that is X. So this is positive charge present. So this is amino acid with a side chain that is positive. So this positive group is completed. Ultimately, on the basis of positivity, so this is one type of amino acid. So all amino acids are positive side chain, and positive side chains are called basic amino acid. So this is the variable group. Ultimately, positive are completed. So if you follow the structure of aspartic acid and glutamic acid, ultimately branch chain, this is branch chain, red like structure or branch chain or variable. This branch chain has negative side chain. So this negativity indicate that are acidic amino acid. So ultimately side chain are divided into two categories, positive and negative. So positive are already completed and negative, those are negative. So negative amino acids are also called acidic amino acid, example aspartic acid and glutamic acid. All are common, NH3+, C++-, H all are common, and all molecule has a particular asymmetric carbon atom. If you follow this branch chain, all are positive side chain, because this is positive and this is positive, this is positive, so positive side chain. So ultimately all are basic amino acid, example lysine, arginine, histidine. So lysine, arginine, histidine, all are basic amino acid. So now time ultimately left uncharged amino acid. So uncharged are divided into two categories, polar and non-polar. Polar means slight charge. So ultimately uncharged mean polar, non-polar. Polar mean slightly charged, non-polar mean fully uncharged. So if you follow the structure of serine or threonine, so this is alpha NH3, this is alpha C++-, this is branch, but this branch do not carry any charge, no positive, no negative, but this is polar group. I will discuss about polar group in next class. This is polar group, that means slightly charged. So this slight charge causes polarity. So this is amino acid is polar side chain, but it is uncharged, because uncharged polar and uncharged non-polar. This is uncharged because equal number of positive and negative number of ion, that's why it is uncharged. But due to this group, that is X group, this is polar. So polar or charged amino acid are always hydrophilic, because they always attract to water. That's why all amino acids are hydrophilic. That's why this term is mentioned here, all are hydrophilic amino acid. So hydrophilic amino acid means positive or negative or uncharged polar. Clear? Uncharged polar. I will discuss about uncharged polar in next class. So if you follow this structure, so that is branch chain that has no charge, because already charged group already they are mentioned above. So this is branch, but that has no charge and that is no polarity. That's why this is uncharged and non-polar. Uncharged and non-polar. So uncharged non-polar amino acids are always hydrophobic. So this is alpha NH3+, this is C++-, this is H, this is X, that is variable group, and this group has no charge, and this group has no polarity. That's why those amino acids are hydrophobic. Example alanine, valine, isoleucine, leucine, methionine, phenylalanine, tyrosine, tryptophan. All are hydrophobic amino acid. So hydrophobicity of a protein depends on the presence of this amino acid that are hydrophobic in nature. Some proteins are hydrophilic in nature due to presence of this amino acid. So I am sure most of the students get clear concept from this class. So everyone ultimately make a clear concept about amino acid, and this structure of amino acids help in studies of structure of protein in next class. I will discuss about just polarity. What do you mean by polarity? O and H. and H. So this is just like covalent bond. But you also know that electronegativity is much more greater than hydrogen. So del minus, and this is del plus, and this is del plus. So this molecule, this is just looks like uncharged, but a polarity is present. This is polarity. But if you follow the structure of carbon dioxide, C double bond O and C double bond O, this is uncharged. But electronegativity, highest del minus, and del plus, and ultimately del from the ultimately attraction from del plus, del minus, and ultimately net force, that is zero. So ultimately net force, so polarity is zero. Polarity is zero. That's why polarity is zero. That's why this is uncharged and non-polar. Clear? So thank you everyone. Please follow this class very carefully. I'm sure everyone make a clear concept about this topic. Thank you.